you've enjoyed a big meal and your stomach feels bloated and gassy.
Everyone leave. I have to poop. Now!
Yep, we've all been there. And you can add constipation to the discomfort.
I haven't taken a crap in over 3 weeks. The question is why?
Your digestive system is a complex ecosystem of bacteria called the microbiome. And what we feed our microbiome can affect our mood and behavior. Which foods are terrible for your gut's health? What are their side effects? This is Your Body On, the top 5 worst foods for your gut. Number 5, artificial sweeteners. You might think that drinking diet soda is healthy, but you'd be surprised. Non-caloric artificial sweeteners, NASs, like aspartame, saccharin, or sucralose, are among the most widely used food additives. They provide a sweet taste without the high-calorie content of sugars. But your body can't digest these chemicals. They pass through your body and negatively alter your microbiome. NASs promote the growth of gut bacteria that pulls energy from your food and turns it into fat. Researchers found that you're more likely to be overweight if you eat non-caloric artificial sweeteners. Your body's tissue may also have difficulty absorbing glucose from your blood. Left unchecked, glucose intolerance can lead to diabetes and higher risks of liver and heart disease. If you're looking for a healthier alternative to diet soda, why not try kombucha? It has plenty of gut-healthy probiotics. Number 4, fried foods. Before you devour those chicken nuggets, you might want to hear this first.
This is the best Kentucky fried chicken I ever had.
The oils used for frying foods are rich in saturated fats and trans fats. They can inhibit healthy bacteria from growing in your gut. The saturated and trans fats also put a strain on your digestive system. They can cause bloating, nausea, and discomfort, as you need a lot of digestive juices like bile and stomach acid to break down the fat. Your gut removes metabolic waste and toxins. You'll have a tougher time getting rid of toxins with an unhealthy gut. They can cause chronic fatigue, illnesses, and inflammation throughout your body. According to research published in the journal Heart, fried food can also increase your risk of heart attack or stroke by 28%. So it's better to eat healthy fats. You can find them in avocados, salmon, or extra virgin olive oil. Now that's a tasty salad. Number 3, processed foods. If you get stomach aches after eating your favorite breakfast cereal, you might want to switch to a healthier brand.
If you're looking for marshmallows, there are none. It's quite bland, I assure you.
Processed foods are the most damaging food to your gut. Fast food, canned veggies, and white bread are full of additives, but they are low in fiber and antioxidants, which we need for healthy gut bacteria. The added sugars in processed foods allow gram-negative bacteria to flourish, which can cause infections. Eating too many processed foods is linked to a higher risk of cardiac strokes and type 2 diabetes. It's better to eat whole foods as they help beneficial microbes grow. Number 2, alcohol. Ever wonder why you get so bloated after a night of drinking? I have a gut feeling you might. Alcohol can have big effects on your gut health. Men who drink more than 2 servings of alcohol a day, or women who drink more than 1 serving of alcohol daily, can harm their gut microbiomes. This can cause dysbiosis, a bacterial imbalance in your gut. If your gut is imbalanced, your immune system isn't working properly. It will be more challenging to stay healthy. So you'd be more prone to acne, acid reflux, and chronic fatigue. Alcohol can also decrease your production of digestive enzymes and juices. Your body would have more trouble breaking down, digesting, and absorbing nutrients from food. You could have bloating, gas, and loose stools, as partially digested food can cause too much fermentation in your gut. I won't drink to that. Number 1, red meat. Vegetarians and vegans, rejoice! Steaks, burgers, pork chops, and more are all bad for your gut. Sorry, barbecue lovers. When our gut bacteria digest choline and carnitine, nutrients in red meats, they make trimethylamine N-oxide, or TMAO. A study found that people who ate red meat as their primary source of protein had 3 times more TMAO than people who ate white meat or plant-based foods. High levels of TMAO in your gut can increase your risk of heart attack, colorectal cancer, and inflammatory bowel disease. Diets rich in fiber and minimally processed animal foods provide good bacteria for a healthy gut. But maybe you'd be better if you didn't eat meat. Think you could stick to a plant-based diet for an entire year?
I don't know.
How much healthier would you be? We'll find out on another episode of Your Body On.